Oh! with his grace, by his power, let the gift of water, as it is sprinkled upon us and throughout this church, may it become a sign of our repentance, a reminder of our baptism, and a symbol of the cleansing of these walls. But first, let us call to mind that we ourselves, who are bound here in faith and love, are the living church, set in the world as a sign and witness of God's love for all. God of mercy, you call every creature to the light of life, surround us with such great love that when we stray, you continually lead us back to Christ our head. For you have established an inheritance of such mercy that those sinners who pass through water made sacred die with Christ and rise restored as members of his body, heirs of his eternal covenant. Bless this water, sanctify it, as it is sprinkled upon us and throughout this church, make it a sign of the saving waters of baptism, by which we become one in Christ, the temple of your Spirit. May all here today, and all those in days to come who will celebrate your mysteries in this church, be united at last in the holy city of your peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. this story clearly brought out a very important fact to me. A building does not make a church. Only people do. The church is much more than the visible structure. It is a community of individual lives which have been cemented together in love. Today, we celebrate the dedication of this beautiful new chapel here at Magdalen College. Yet, we celebrate something much more than this visible accomplishment. We celebrate the much deeper reality to which this chapel gives witness. A community of faith here at Magdalen College. This building represents the work, sacrifice, the hundreds of hours of volunteer service which have been spent to bring this chapel to completion. Today we see here what the church is really all about. A community of persons founded in love on the person of Jesus Christ. His magnificent first letter to the Corinthians, St. Paul tells us that all of us are God's building. We are the living stone, which are all fitted together to make up the building of God. These are the stones of our own unique individual lives, with our own particular stories and backgrounds, all of us different, and all different sizes and colors, of different colors and textures. These have all been gloriously put together to make up the building of God, which is the church. Here at Taekwondo College, it is quite clear what are the living stones which make up the community of the church which this beautiful chapel represents. They are the lives, the sacrifices, and the work of so many dedicated people who have been inspired by the dream of establishing this Catholic college. Another point, however, is absolutely essential to understanding what the Catholic Church is all about and what we are all about as Christians. St. Paul says that the living stones which we are, the individual and unique parts which go to make up this building of God, must in fact be promptly fitted together, or else the building will not exist. A firm foundation is essential to construct this building and to keep its parts together. What holds this community together here at Magdalen College is the strong foundation which Paul says is in his beautiful letter to the Ephesians, is Christ Jesus himself. He is the cornerstone, and through him, all the individual living stones, which we are fitted together. Christ Jesus himself is the foundation and the cornerstone which holds the community of Magdalen College together in love. There is an added meaning to our dedication of this chapel today because we are also celebrating the great feast of the Immaculate Conception of Mary. We honor Mary because she is the mother of Jesus, the Son of God. And what we celebrate today is our belief that because of her special role in the history of salvation, Mary was privileged by God to be born free from original sin. Yet, the greatness of Mary also lies in the fact that she was willing to respond to God's wonderful invitation, absolutely and without reserve. "I am the servant of the Lord," said Mary. "Let it happen to me as you say." Her entire life was dedicated to God and her Son, Christ Jesus. In the fullest sense, then, Mary is the first disciple of Jesus himself, since from the very beginning she was willing to follow him faithfully and lovingly. She is without question the model of what it means to be a Christian and a disciple of Jesus, and the model of what it means to be a living stone in the building of God, which is the church. Today, as we dedicate this chapel, brothers and sisters, our community rejoices as it comes together to bless this altar. Let us ask God to look kindly upon the church's offering placed upon it and to receive his people as an everlasting gift. Blessed are you, Lord our God, who accepted the sacrifice of Christ, offered on the altar of the cross for the salvation of the world. Now, with a father's love, you call your people to celebrate his memory by coming together at his table. May this altar, which we have built for your holy mystery, be the center of our praise and thanksgiving. May it be the table at which we break the bread which gives us life, and drink the cup which makes us one. May it be the fountain of the unfailing waters of salvation. Here may we draw close to Christ, the living stone, and in him grow into a holy temple. Here may our lives of holiness become a pleasing sacrifice to your glory. sisters, pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Praise. Christ, your only Son, our Lord. The day before he suffered, he took bread in his sacred hand, and looking up in heaven to you, his almighty Father, he gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. Gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
Trust in your mercy and love. Do not